This is amazing. I am sitting in Chris's truck. He is getting in. I am buckled up, ready to go. Mitchell's leaving me, and I'm gonna go digging in a place that I never thought I'd get the opportunity to. And then it's a dream come true. I'm ready. Let's go.
Here.
It's my first find here with JCW Digger. I cannot believe it. Boy, it was a clear tone, 75, 76, and it wasn't very deep at all. And my first time ever using my camera underwater to go see what it is. Let's go see, because the water's so beautiful. Okay. Is that a Sharps?
Richmond Lab Sharps.
Yeah. My dear sweet Lord, that's amazing.
That's Confederate bullet.
A Confederate bullet. All the bullets I've found have been Union. This is my first Confederate bullet ever. Oh my God, and it's perfect. It's dropped. Wow. Looky there. That's good. That's a goodie, guys. That's a goodie. Whew. My heart is pounding. It's treasure to be had. Go get it. Wait, y'all see this? Maybe he won't swim away before I get him on video. He's gone. Let's see if I can find what my target is. Ah, Pepsi.
Yep.
Yeah, it gets me every time.
It was in the sand. I was kind of figuring it'd be trash.
Okay, so I have a coin in my hand. I do not know what kind of coin in my hand, but I have a coin. It could be a Lincoln. It could be anything. An Indian head penny.
Is it?
Yeah.
I dug that other one right back behind it.
1889. Oh my God. The only other Indian head I've ever dug was 1890. So this is the oldest coin I've ever dug. Oh my God. It's in pretty darn good shape. Like, you can see like stuff around the, you can see feathers and everything. I'm trying not to flip out. I promised I wouldn't flip out. It's got a shield on the back and it's 1 cent, and then like you can see feathers, details, and you can see like little edges and stuff.
Yeah, it's in good shape. About like the mother two I found.
Look, it's still got like shiny on it.
Yeah, you know, it's 'cause it's like been in the water.
Like the rim is beat up though. I don't care, but I am dying. All right, here. I didn't have the camera rolling. Because I didn't even think about it. And it is my very first bullet sinker. And I said that I really, really wanted to dig one of these one day. And I also said that I wouldn't flip out. Okay, so after that sinker bullet, getting a little bit of calm down. There's a good signal right here. Down in the bedrock crack, and it's a good consistent 75-76, and I've pretty much found it with the pinpointer. I'm gonna have to find the pinpointer. Well, I said I found it. So the master and commander over here pulls out two bullets while I'm still digging for my one. So what's this bullet, master and commander? Just a three or under. Ah, pish posh. No big deal. No big deal. Show your other bullet.
No, just a Williams cleaner.
Not just. It's just. I love how you say just. That's fantastic. I love that. So I couldn't dig those signals because I was still digging this out of a crack in the bedrock. It's another coin. Yes, I know. Be amazed, all you people out there. I found a coin. I found something, finally. What is it? Ooh, it's another Indian and penny. Oh my God, what year are you? Hi, Lady Liberty. 1904? It's bent. Look how bent it is, man. It was really jammed down in there. I cannot believe that. I have physically, like, been part of or found and retrieved three Indian and pennies. That's fantastic, guys. Ooh, look. Say hello, Lady Liberty. Well, if it wasn't bent, it would be in good shape, too. Like, I see details on feathers. I see little dots around the edges. 1 cent, 1904. Wow. That is so cool. It almost looks like something's wrong with the date. Maybe it's just something on there. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. All right. There it is. It is a hunk of lead. Yay. It is a... Oh, it's the same kind of bullet I dug. So it's another Sharps. A Confederate Sharps. Dropped. Beautiful. Almost smooth. Looky there. Woohoo! Lucky, lucky, lucky! I am the luckiest woman on the face of the planet. Look at that. I would not want to get hit with one of those. Ever. Anywhere. I wouldn't want to get hit in the finger with one of those. Nah. I also found some turds. No. I'm having a blast. This is going to be my second bullet. And I got a bullet sinker. And I got some coins. And I don't even... Let's go find some more. Quit talking, Megan. Be quiet. Well, I must say that seeing it in video and seeing it in person, it's just fantastic. I gotta get a video of him fanning. Stuff is awesome. Right there, under my claw. Right here.
okay with us?
No, no. It's not fair.
No.
I didn't come here to find a memorial.
We just found two Indian heads. So.
Oh, God. No, I saw the back and I was like, God, please, God, don't be a memorial. It's the ugliest memorial penny I ever saw.
All right. So this was around the mid-70s. And this is what I saw so far, and it appears to be a piece of lead. Could be a sinker, could be a shot bullet, could be a modern bullet. But it looks very round.
Split shot.
Split shot? Yeah, I said it could be a sinker. Well, we can't all find the good stuff. Well, you know, if I turn that over this way and I display it like that, I could act like it's a buck ball. Is that what size they are?
Until you just fight and find them things. Oh, you don't even need a metal detector.
You don't even need a metal detector?
No.
I've heard that said before by other people. Well, one other person.
I'm serious. You don't even need a metal detector. You just go through with the pinpoint and just... I'm serious. You don't believe me?
No, I believe you. But what I'm saying is that I've heard that said by another person before. Do you know who said that?
No.
You don't even need a metal detector?
Me?
He doesn't know that Nugget Noggin says that all the time.
Oh, yeah, he does say that all the time.
Yeah. Don't even need a metal detector, just pish posh. Just find him all the time, right?
Yep.
No big deal, right? Chris and I were out of the creek after finding a couple of bullets and a bullet sinker and a couple of Indian heads and, a couple of more small bullets. We got out of the creek. Of course, Chris stomped me. I did find the first bullet, but he just wiped me clean because he knows how to find stuff in the creek, and he really is a great teacher. Thank you, Chris. Teaching me about how to put the mask on and how to spit in it. Mm-hmm. So we've come over here to a house that he's hunted up for, that he has permission for, that was built in 1890s or maybe even up to 1900. Beautiful home, been redone, lots of land outside, and he's went in to ask for permission from me. I'll let you know. This place is beautiful. This whole entire area is beautiful. I haven't seen not one thing here that wasn't beautiful. I love it. God. I think I'm gonna move here. Man. While Chris is in the house, I just wanted y'all to know something. I saw his rod. I saw his big, huge, long rod. He let me see it. He let me touch it. Okay, let me touch his rod. It's big. It's long. It's a big round. I like to hold it. I love holding a big, long rod that is holding the big coil for the AT Pro and the AT Gold. Y'all perverted. Y'all dirty-minded. You need to get your minds out the gutter. That ain't right. That ain't right, y'all. Perverts. Get your mind out the gutter. Shame, W. So what did you get there, Chris? Right here by the truck.
Iron.
An iron. Which is crazy. You got an iron signal. What did that iron signal give you? That's so cool. Oh my word. And it was not deep.
Nah, yeah, it wasn't deep at all.
That's so cool. I've seen people dig them. I've never seen one.
That ain't my first one.
Oh, I'm sure. It's so heavy.
Yeah, they're heavy.
My wrist is killing me. All right, man. Well, what do you tell everybody at home?
Probably been run over a few times. Laying right there in the ground. This is how deep it was. Can't believe I missed that thing before. Just, I guess I never dug that big iron.
Look at that. Dedication. Down on his knees. Just loves it.
1944 week penny.
Aw. I got a nut. I love it when this happens. I am working my way around the base of the old clothesline. And I got a 77, 78 signal. It was high pitch, so it sounded good. And this popped out on my shovel. I hadn't even touched it yet. Get my shovel on me. Got my office button. Of course, it's a clad dime. It's like 4 inches deep. My luck. Whew. All right, probably a 65 too. That's the way stuff's going for me. Actually, no, I can't say that. I have a freaking fantastic day. 83. I have found your sperm. The count for your sperm is 1. Hey everybody, I got this signal here and started out 80-81 and turned 90 degrees and it was like 80-45, but it was still good. Yeah, I kissed it with my shovel right there, but I do believe that's some camp lead. What do you think? See where I kissed it right there on the end, on the fat end?
Yeah, it's...
It's melted lead either way, isn't it?
Nope, it's aluminum.
It's aluminum? Yep. Oh, man. Aw. You cheater. What a liar. Lying broken sperm. Let's see. This was a really good 75 signal. 75, 76. And it came out of the ground. Corroded and broken, and at first I thought it was a Coke bottle opener. Now I'm not quite sure what it is. It's already broken. I guess I'll just finish it off. See, I thought it was a Coke bottle opener, like this. But that piece is missing, so I'm not sure what it is. If I find out, I'll let you know. Thanks for watching. On to the next.
So, like literally, I dug that last thing that I thought was a Coke bottle opener right there, and then right here so I'm not sure. Alright, well, it seems shallow enough that I might be able to pop it up with y'all on camera. I hope so. Chris let me borrow a shovel. I had my shovel and he said, no, we'll be water hunting all day. You won't need that. Yeah. I thought that last thing was going to be a zinc penny. It wasn't. So let's see what this is. Both my pro pointers are at Garrett and Janet. All right. Thank you. I think it's just a piece of that thing. I think it is. Yep. Just a shallow piece of that. Alright. This has just come up out of the hole. I am near the house, the back side of this late 1800s to the turn of the century house. Oh, crud, Megan, really? Rub it a little harder next time. I think that might have been mother of pearl. Maybe that's just corrosion. I don't even know what this is, really. A button or something? I don't know. But it sure is shiny. I'd like to have that shiny smile. I'll let you know. Once again, the Garrett AT Pro's done it. And I got me a big old chunk of lead. Carved on, maybe. Looks like it. You know, I don't know what I did to be privileged enough to earn the right to come and dig here. But I am humbled and I'm honored and I'm grateful for this opportunity. I saw stuff today that I would have never got to see at home or dig at home. We don't have stuff like this. Thank you, Chris. Thank you. I don't know how I'll ever repay you. You are a kind soul, a true gentleman. Thank you.
You say, thanks for watching, be blessed, and happy hunting.